Microsoft Flow is fantastic for triggering and executing workflows in many different applications. Vivian is showing us how you can connect Azure IoT Central, which is your IoT app application, to Microsoft Flow to trigger flows when something happens on your devices. Hi everyone, this is the Internet of Things show. I'm Olivier, your host, and I'm with Vivian today. How are you, Vivian?
Hi, I'm doing very well, thank you.
Good. So Vivian is here to show us how you connect an Azure IoT Central application to the rest of the world, right? To the big world. And for that, she's going to use Microsoft Flow. But before that, how about you introduce yourself and tell people who you are?
Hi everyone, I'm Vivian. I work on Azure IoT Central. I'm a program manager on the team and I'm working on the extensibility portion of IoT Central.
So IoT Central is our SaaS offering for IoT, right? So basically super easy to deploy, click, 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 and you have a website that you can play around with, create device templates, create users, roles, dashboards, and so on. Well, you guys should try that if you have not yet. But as you were saying, there's an extensibility, there's a connectivity to the rest of the world, right? It's collecting data from devices, extracting insights is not it. So today you came to show us how to use Microsoft Flow for doing that connection, right?
That's right.
How does it look like?
So what we're going to do today is we're going to connect a IoT Central application through Microsoft Flow to actually a Microsoft Teams channel so that when a device fires a rule in your IoT Central application, a message gets posted in your Teams channel so that you can, you know, visit all the instances of when the rule was triggered so that you can look at the history of the rules being fired.
Okay. Let's
do
it.
Let's begin. All right. So here we are in my IoT Central application. I'm on the home page. Let me go to a specific device. I'm going to go to the rules page. So I'll visit this particular device.
Yeah.
So you can see this is a simulated device. It already has some data flowing through it.
Okay.
We're going to build a new rule on this.
Okay. And if people want to follow along while you're showing that, actually, you're using one of the templates that we have in IoT Central, which is the Contoso one, right?
That's right. This is the Contoso app template. And you can basically create a new application. And you can choose, I want a sample Contoso template. And this is exactly what you're going to get.
Okay. And you're going to get these simulated devices that show data.
Okay. That's correct.
Perfect.
That's correct. All right. So let's go to the rules section. In the rules section, you'll notice there's already a rule that's been created. I'm just going to create a new one. I'll change it to edit template. I'll create a new rule. Let's make a telemetry rule. Let's say this is a rule that monitors when the pressure is too high.
Okay.
All right. So I'll call it pressure alert. All right. And I'll create the conditions of the rule. So this is what defines when the rule is going to be triggered. And I'm going to say when the pressure value is... let's say higher than, I'm going to say, I'll give it, let's say 20 PSI, something like that. All right. And then I'm going to save the rule. And this is the interesting part. So we're going to add a new action.
Okay.
And you'll see here a list of actions that we have available today. I'm going to zoom in on the Microsoft Flow one. And this is what launches us into Microsoft Flow. So a little bit about Microsoft Flow. So Flow is a service that basically lets you build wonderful workflows, automate workflows across many different applications and services. And it's a very simple interface. It's drag and drop, no code necessary. And you can use the hundreds of connectors that are available in the library today to build these workflows that suit your needs.
Yeah, I love Flow. Like my first Flow was actually to get a notification on my phone when my boss is sending me an email. Right. That's the
application.
That's the one of the templates that we have up there, right?
Yep. It's a perfect application of Flow. And you can do it just really easily within a minute. You've got this automated workflow set up, right? So let's jump into this. So if I click Microsoft Flow, I'm launched into the Flow experience here. So right now I'm in Microsoft Flow and you see that I've been launched into this experience where I will basically be able to configure the connection. And I'm using a Azure IoT Central connector that has already been published.
Okay.
And I'll be able to choose a custom action. So I can choose other connectors that will create this workflow.
So to connect this connector, this flow connector to IoT Central, the credentials you're using are one of the users that are registered on the IoT Central app, right?
That's correct.
Are there limitations in terms of you have to be a builder, an admin, or an operator? Or?
So the limitations of this are you have to be an AAD user, first of all.
Okay.
That's existing limitation. We're exploring ways around that. But you have to be an AAD user. And also, in order to build this rule itself, you have to be an administrator or a builder.
Or a builder.
Or a builder.
Okay.
Yep. So if I hit continue. Okay. So we have the beginnings of our flow.
Okay.
Here we'll have to choose our application. And we'll have a drop down. You can enter the ID of the application, but I'm going to choose the application by its name, which was Contoso.
Okay.
I'll pick the rule that I just created, which is the high pressure alert.
Okay.
And let's add a new step. And when we add a new step, we're picking from various other connectors that are already published.
And this is the hundreds of them.
Hundreds of connectors that are available. Exactly. So I'm going to specifically choose the Teams one. I want to go. I want to post a message to Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams. All right. So I'm going to post a message to Teams when this rule fires.
Okay.
All right. I'll have to pick my team ID.
So like for each connector, you log in into the connectors, there's like these settings so that you have access to your channels.
Correct.
And so on.
Each connector has its own connections so that you are able to pick, you know, which accounts you want to use with which connector.
Makes sense.
And it nicely, you know, segments your connectors so that you don't have to manage the credentials except on a one-by-one basis.
Did we say that Microsoft Flow is free to use?
Microsoft Flow is free for, I think there are limitations, but there is a free tier.
Yeah.
There
so if you're building your IoT app, like for, like I did a chores monitor with IoT Central and a button for my kids to make sure they do the chores. and basically, I'm not paying for Flow.
There's a free tier, and there's also a nice tier that comes with your Office 365 subscription or your Dynamics subscription, and that gives you a couple more Flow runs, and you know it gives you a little bit more. But there is a free tier that any Microsoft account user can use.
Sorry for the interruption.
No worries. Here we go. So here I'm going to pick my team ID, and I believe the team that I want to post in is Contoso.
Okay.
And then I pick a channel ID, and here I created a device chat channel, and this is where my device is expected. All my devices are expected to post messages there. And this part is super duper cool. This is where I compose the actual message that this workflow will send into the Teams channel. Mm-hmm. And I can pick from a variety of dynamic content that comes from the actual rule.
Yeah.
So here I can pick, for example, the device name. So device name, fired rule name. I'm going to pick a rule name.
Yeah.
At, and I can pick my timestamp.
Okay.
With a value of, and I can here enter, I can here specify a dynamic content that is the actual pressure value that triggered the alert.
Okay.
So if I hit see more, you'll see one of the items that showed up was
pressure. Which is pressure. The actual value that triggered
exactly.
it.
Exactly. Okay. So if I hit pressure, and let's say this is the entire message that I want to send.
Yep.
So now I'll hit save.
Yep. And the flow is deployed, running for you.
And it's called run a custom action when IoT Central rule is fired. And you can change the name up here.
Okay.
And I'll, if I go back, okay. Yep. Okay, so it takes a moment for everything underneath to set up, and then we'll see messages show up in the Teams channel. But in the meantime, you'll see that a new action has automatically shown up in your IoT Central rule so that the registration has happened underneath this, underneath the hood. So now, whenever this rule is triggered, we should see a new message in the device chat channel.
That shows up.
And that should show up. Here we go. So we have a new message. And you see this is exactly what we composed. with the dynamic content. So it's telling me this device name fired this rule at this time with this pressure value.
Awesome. And it shows that it's coming from you because you were logged in Flow.
That's correct.
For that connector, for the Teams connector yourself.
That's correct.
Eventually you can think about a way to do that, like creating an account specially for sending data from the IoT Central application.
You'll notice in the connections pane, it shows that the account that was connected to the Teams connector is actually my personal account, which is why it shows up as me in the Teams channel.
Yep. This is a great demo. Love it. So this is limitless, actually. Once you're in functions, once you actually trigger, Microsoft Flow in there with all the connectors, click, drag, whatever. It's super straightforward to do.
Absolutely.
And it can do whatever you want in there.
And you can see, actually, the library of connectors. There are many, many connectors out there. So if I scroll past, hold on. If I look at just standard connectors, there are tons and tons of connectors available that you can choose from.
Awesome. Love it. Thanks, Vivian, a lot for this demo.
Thank you.
Hope you liked it. You can check out some of the links that are below in the description of this video to learn more and to try out what Vivian just demoed, connecting Microsoft Flow to IoT Central. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.